Hello everyone, it's Shane Kanto, your Wasteland reviewer, and here we are, number 5 of my top 10 scenes in film, and it's The Dawn of Man from 2001 A Space Odyssey. And if any of you have watched my review for that film or listened to me talk about some of my favorite films, 2001 A Space Odyssey means a lot to me. The funny thing is, the background on my computer at work is the monolith with the sun from The Dawn of Man. Oh, I'm gonna jump into the cinematography already. I'm gonna take a step back. 2001 A Space Odyssey, Stanley Kubrick's amazing, amazing sci-fi magnum opus. One of the greatest science fiction films ever made. And this film is so breathtaking, so atmospheric, so amazing. And I know some people think it's really boring and a drag. I'm not going to say you're wrong. It's how you feel. It's not how I feel. I love this film, and Kubrick's one of my favorite directors ever, and what he's able to do. Specifically, I'm going to talk about The Dawn of Man, the beginning part of this film, where we get to see the evolution of these ape-type creatures who connect with this giant black monolith that winds up helping them evolve and giving them the ability to use tools and stand on 2 feet and evolve, jump into the future. The cinematography done by Jeffrey Unsworth, breathtakingly gorgeous. Some of the greatest shots I have ever seen in film are from this film, and specifically from this section of the film. From the dawn, literally starts with the dawn, but the music as well. This opens up with the "Thus Spoke Zarathustra," the doom 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 doom. Sorry, but just that opening moment of this convergence and looking at this film and jumping in and seeing this dawn. This whole opening sequence has no dialogue. It's a bunch of ape people and humans in costumes, and very believable too. And like, this is around-ish the time of Planet of the Apes, and this, what they were able to do with just watching the solitary ape people, and for like 15 minutes just watching them groom each other, watching them hunt, interacting with each other, and everything seems so beautiful, beautifully shot on like location, and this desert is breathtakingly gorgeous. But the true moments, the second that this one ape wakes up and looks up and you see something, it can see something, and you're sitting there thinking, what is this? And then you see the shot, this giant black slab standing up in the middle of them, and the music is so haunting and creepy, just like that, like people like doing these chants, and it's so unnerving, and you don't know what's gonna happen. And this one ape slowly coming closer, and it's like, do I touch it, do I don't touch it? And finally just like embracing it and putting its hand up on it, and they all start coming up. And then the shot when that camera looks straight up and you see the monolith standing tall with the sun coming over it, that is the shot on my computer at work, because it is so beautiful. I would hang that in my room as a picture, because it is so symmetrically, breathtakingly gorgeous, and so mysterious all at once. What is this? And we don't know at this point. And it's like, what is this thing? And then, all of a sudden, they're standing up. And the shot of the one ape sitting there with a bunch of bones. It picks up one of the bones, starts swinging back and forth. Music starting to build, starting to build, starting to build, and it swinging back and forth, and then realizing, bang, bang, and one of the, there's two amazing, amazing cuts in this scene. The first one brings it up, smashes down the bone into a skull of a tapir, and then it cuts to it bashing in one of a living tapir and hunting, and it's like, you realizing this thing can hunt now. It has evolved. It is taking steps into the future. And just seeing this all unfold and watching this evolution in front of you is so fascinating and interesting. It doesn't need to say anything. You're just taking it all in. And that camera pointed up at this ape, and it seems like it's towering over us as an audience, bringing down this bone. And then the climax, when we're dealing with these two tribes. And now we see there's a difference, because earlier you see them like yelling back and forth at each other across this little thing of water. Now we have the one standing up, bones in hand, and the other one's on the other side, and you see evolution coming to a head in this frame. They're standing tall on this other side, and we're like on closer end of the frame, hesitant, and one comes running over. And then that's the moment, bashed over the head, and that is when man is born, and we can kill, and kills this ape, and bashes them in, and scares away the rest of them. And it's like, and this is that moment where man leaps forward and becomes the one in control, because we have the ability to think and utilize these tools, and we use them for violence. And that's a big theme in a lot of Kubrick films. If you look with my good old ultra-violence poster up in the back from Clockwork Orange, the whole film's about that. And that moment, and one of the greatest, greatest dissolve cut edits ever, when the apes finally flings up that bone and it's flying through the air, flying through the air, and we see this tool flying through the sky, and then boom, turns into a spaceship and jumps into the next section of the film. Another tool, just a more advanced tool, and it's just like, holy crap, this scene was amazing. And if you really allow yourself to sit there and really take in everything, the music, the cinematography, just Kubrick's attention to detail and what he's trying to convey here with the evolution.